Are you thinking about installing a solar panel system, or do you have one and want to compare yours to other systems? If so, stay tuned. Today I'm going to share with you how our four-year-old system performed over the years and if it matched the criterions that we thought it would at the beginning. Our system is a DIY, do-it-yourself system. I purchased all the material and installed most of it until I had to work and my husband had to finish it doing the wiring. It's a grid-tied system mounted to a flat roof. Colorado is one of the best places to install a solar panel system because the sun shines 300 days a year and it's a mile up, so it's not too warm. This video contains three parts: the financials, the installation, and the performance over the 4 years it's been in place. So let's get started. So these are the main parts and the material costs of our system. Our system is a 2.64 kilowatt system. To calculate the annual production of the solar panel system, multiply the kilowatts by the localization factor. In Colorado, that's 1.6, so you'd end up at about 4,300 kilowatt hours. The localization factor does not vary very much within the US. At the time, 4,300 kilowatt hours per year was enough to cover our usage. Now we're replacing our gas furnace with electric heating and we'll expand our solar panel system to cover the additional kilowatt hours per year. The average American household uses a little over 10,000 kilowatt hours per year. These numbers are from 2017. I'll show you in a little bit that prices of solar watt panels have dropped since then. We used 8 325 watt panels. The main parts add up to $4,522. Back then there was a tax credit of 30%. Today that's 26%. And CSU, Colorado Springs Utilities, gave us an additional incentive of $690. In addition to the main parts, we paid about $300 for the permits and about $600 for smaller parts that we mainly got from Home Depot. This is the NREL PV system cost benchmark from 2010 to 2020. Prices decreased significantly in all sectors, residential, commercial, and utility scale. Since we installed our system in 2017, the price of residential PV decreased from $2.94 to $2.71 per watt. Two-thirds of the total cost of the PV systems are soft costs. That means labor costs for the installation of the system. Today, solar panels or modules are available for as little as 50 cents per watt. In this figure, you can see that the soft cost for residential photovoltaic increased from about 50% in 2010 to about 64% in 2020. The higher the soft cost, so the cost for the installation of the system, the more attractive do-it-yourself becomes. In case you're not up for the upfront cost, there's many ways to finance solar panel systems. You can pay as little as $50 per month for a $21,900 solar panel system. Overall, from a financial perspective, the solar panel system was definitely worth it for us. We got a great deal on the material and we made use of the state's and the utility's incentives. So if you're interested in buying or building a solar panel system, you should definitely look into incentives. Although even without incentives, it's worth the cost, the upfront cost in most locations, since the prices have dropped over the years significantly. Now let's look into the installation and the technical details of the solar panel system. Our solar panel system is oriented southeast. We're pretty happy with this arrangement because we still get a lot of production in the afternoon. Most households use electricity in the morning and in the evening. So if you manage to arrange some of your panels southeast and some southwest, that would be great. This is the wiring diagram of the solar panel system. To the left, you have the 8 solar modules with an optimizer for each. We use 325 watt Solar World modules. Solar modules typically have a warranty of 25 years. You shouldn't have to make use of the warranty. However, if you have to, you want to make sure that the company is still around. So choose a healthy company to purchase your modules from. If you precisely want to determine how much sun you have at a specific location throughout the day, you can use a Pathfinder. However, we didn't need it because at our place the sun shines almost all day and we don't have any obstacles like trees in the way. We chose the iron-rich mounting system. Since we have a flat roof, we used a tilt of 30 degrees. In the 4 years it's been in place, we had quite a few storms and no issues whatsoever. You can find a link to all the details of the mounting system in the description below. Over the past decade, solar panel systems have massively evolved, and now for most locations there are really attractive systems available on the market. We are very thankful that over the past 4 years our system has provided us with the energy as expected, and we're looking forward to many more years. Now let me walk you through the details of our performance numbers. This is our last bill. Let's have a look at the electric charge. So the energy provided by the grid was 322 kilowatt hours, and the energy sent to the grid was 208 kilowatt hours. Colorado Springs Utilities has a net metering program for grid-tied solar panel systems. So if you underproduce, like in this case, your utility will charge you the difference. To access the grid as a perfect battery, if you will, you pay a flat rate of $15. Let me show you the inverse example. This is an invoice of July 2020. The system produced 317 kilowatt hours, so the production was almost double as much as the kilowatt hours used. So that month we overproduced 163 kilowatt hours. Since the total net metering credit balance is 282 kilowatt hours, there has been credit already added to the account. The collected kilowatt hour credits can be used up within the next 12 months. Our system also has solar edge monitoring, which provides you with detailed insight into your solar panel system performance. You can see the current power production and continuous data throughout the lifetime of the system. This is an example of the power production in mid-June 2020. This is the power production that week, and this is the power production that month. You can also compare the power production in different years. I think it's interesting to see that during the weakest months, November and December, the production still stays well above 200 kilowatt hours. That's it for now about the financials, the installation, and the production of our solar panel system. Let me know what your thoughts are. If you got value out of this, I'd very much appreciate if you could subscribe below the video. And see you in the next video. Bye.